systems and innovative plastic products for the global market for water supply, drainage, sewage and water reuse. We have great expertise in R&D, more related to the polypropylene piping systems, and which we bring also to the Indian plumbing industry. We are the first PP or polypropylene manufacturing base in India, or the domestic sewage discharge system in the market. Hulet India specializes in ultrasilent, which is an acoustic pipe and fitting, and also the ST Pro system for the drainage systems. If you see the product range which we have ultrasilent, which is an acoustic product, ST Pro. We have Clear Black, which is a solution for the sewage treatment plant. We have PPR pipes, which we have, will be bringing in short time. We have PEX pipe, and we have multi-layer composite pipe. All the three products, the last three products, we will be bringing in the due course. Just to brief you about a little bit about the material which we are talking about, the polypropylene, which has been the in thing for us, which is the heart of our entire system. The density of polypropylene is 0.95 to 0.92 grams per centimeter cube. If you talk about polypropylene, it belongs to a group of polyolefins and it's partially crystallized and non-polar. Its property are similar to the polyethylene, but it is slightly harder and more heat resistance. Polypropylene at the room temperature is resistant to fat and almost all organic solvents. So it is highly chemical resistant. Most importantly, it is also 100% recyclable. So we don't leave any, you know, pollutants on the earth. Yeah, I would like to do a little small technical comparison between the polypropylene and the PVC. If you see the comparative statements, which I have showed as a technical comparison, the density of polypropylene is 0.95 vis-a-vis PVC, which is 1.39 to 1.4. The thermal conductivity, which we are talking about, is for the polypropylene is 0.2 and for PVC it is 0.15. The linear coefficient of expansion, which is very, very crucial for us in India because we have a temperature variation across the zones. So if you talk about the coefficient of expansion, thermal expansion, it is 1.3 into 10 100 raised to minus 3 for polypropylene and 8 into 10 raised to minus 5 for the PVC. Let us come to the next slide, which is we go to the product details now. I first come to the product which is called as an ST Pro. What is ST Pro? ST Pro is a multi-layer, triple layer pipe, which is made of three layers. External layer is gray layer, which is made of polypropylene. The intermediate layer is made of polypropylene, provides the stiffness to the pipe. And the inner layer is made of white polypropylene, which gives the best flow because the surface is smooth and it has a high resistance to chemical agent and it gives a high definition contrast for the visual inspection. To further reiterate about my subject on ST Pro, this piping system is for the waste and drainage system inside the building application area B. And system is suitable for drainage fluid complies to the ISO specification. It has a hot water resistance, 95 degrees centigrade for the short term, 60 degrees centigrade for the permanent load. If you talk about the fire rating systems, the fire rating system, it complies to the EN specifications of 4102-2. Classification, we talk about B2 for the smoke development and for the drip formation, it is TR1. And the product is manufactured as per the compliance of EN 1451-1. The advantage of this system, it is a three-layer pipe, which is made of polypropylene. It is a halogen and cadmium free. It has an increased pipe thickness. The series is H16 for an excellent performance. It has a low thermal expansion. Expansion ratio, if you talk about, is 0.1% for polypropylene. For PVC, it is 1.8%. It is highly chemical resistant to all the industrial wastewater from PS2 to PS12. It is 100% recyclable. We talk about 100% leak-proof product because it's a ring-fit jointing systems. We come to the next product, which we are talking about, is an ultrasilent, which is called as an acoustic piping. Now, to understand ultrasilent, we first understand what is a sound. So, when we come to the ultrasilent, why do we need acoustic solution? Now, if you really see, the noise is divided into noise travel is divided by in two parts. One is an airborne, which is transfers the noise through the air to us. So airborne noise occurs when a noise of a sound source is transferred directly through the air to the human ears. There is another way where the noise can transfer, which is through the structural. That is called as a structural borne noise. It is when the sound transfers first through a solid body, the solid only vibrates and passes the vibration to the human ear as an airborne noise. Now, Hulet as such, has done quite an R&D and a development for the ultra silent material, and it has produced an acoustic material for the piping system. And the noise reduced drainage in the home is not only about the environmental quality, but indeed also the quality for the life. If you see this table which I have shown you, from the jet aircraft to the ultra silent, if you see the real sound decibel of a jet aircraft is 140 decibels, whereas ultra silent we are talking about 19 decibels. You can understand what we are talking about, 140 to 19. Acoustic sound proofing. We have tested our pipes at the Fraunhofer lab, which is one of the finest lab to test the acoustic properties of this particular material, and it is one of the biggest lab. And ultra silent falls into the category of 19 decibel for a 4 liters per second with our Hewlett clamps, and this is in accordance with EN14366. If you talk about ultra silent, what is the structural structure made of? The ultra silent is made of, again, the 3 layers. The external layer is made of black polypropylene. It is marked with the Hewlett trademark, which is having a 4 green marks. And with the black color, we provide an excellent UV resistance properties. The middle layer is made of PPMD, what you call as a polypropylene mineral density. This is the compound which is our patent, and this gives the acoustic property for the material. The inner layer internal layer which we talk about is made of white polypropylene. Again, it gives for the best flow performance and high definition to contrast for the visual monitoring and control. If any care to be taken. The advantage, we talk about best acoustic performance for the material. We follow the EN specification of 13501. It is a hot water resistance. The temperature range is from minus 20 to 95 degrees. Pipes and fittings are UV protected. What are the further product features of this particular thing? We have ultra ring stiffness, which definitely helps out, which gives the strength for the material. We have a clever design, which it gives an ultra discharge rate and ultra smooth flow for the material, for the drainage, wastewater and the soil to pass through. If we talk about the next product features which we have in our product, we have the depth gauge, which is where the pipe is inserted inside the fitting, which is 69 mm vis-a-vis 54 mm. So we have an extra socket depth. If we talk about the next features, we have what we call as the stop end, or we call as a depth gauge. So this tells us up to how much depth we have to fix inside the pipe. So what is the depth engagement we are talking about, and it helps us also in easy assembly, and ultra silent is very simple to handle also. If we talk about accessories, I told you about the Hewlett clamps. With the Hewlett clamps, we have achieved about 19 decibels. We have on acoustic clamps. Now this acoustic clamps are made of structural rubber profile with a hollow sections with a maximum pipe grip, and it gives a minimal vibrational intensity which pass through the constructive material. And rubber softness level is what you call as 40 plus or minus 5 shores, which is as per the international standards. If you talk about connection methods, we can have a sliding bracket mounted in the upper third of the floors with the rubber brackets only lightly touching to the pipes. And then we can have a fixed bracket mounted in the lower third of the floor heights. So this is all the guidelines which we give also during the installation time. What are the incorrect methods of tightening and correct methods of tightening? You should not tighten the entire clamp, totally. You should have a 5 mm gap because there are chances of thermal expansion and contraction during that temperature variation. So this is always a better option to have a gap of 5 mm before you tighten it. We have a pressure clamps. These pressure clamps are generally used for parking lot ceilings or exposed rainwater pipes and blind pipes for sewage drainage. The pressure rating is 6 bars for this. We have another product which is a very, very crucial product. When the pipe passes through from one slab to another slab through a core cutting, this is what you call as an ultra seal product. This is a product which doesn't allow any water to seep through the floor to the ceiling of the next person below him. So this is the best product. It also avoids the structural bond noise to pass across. We have another product, what we call as a lock seal. This lock seal is generally used where you do your drainage product or you lay your drainage system when you are doing a pre-casting. Generally in India, we don't do any pre-casting. the drainage products, the drainage is laid only after the casting has been done. But if you are doing a drainage system which is laid during the casting process or prior to the casting process, prior to the cement slurry pouring, this is the best product which has to be used for connecting the pipes and the fittings or connecting two pipes together. So it gives you easy and fast assembly, safe installation, no tools required for this particular thing. The advantage application is prevents the concrete slurry from infiltration, the gaskets and the decreasing the sealing quality. It protects also the push-fit connection against lift force generated during the concrete drying. Because when concrete dries, there is chances of contraction. So it will try to lift the pipes upwards. So this avoids that. The other accessories we have what you call as an end clock or is called as an end cap. So if you have to end the pipe at certain position, you can use this particular end cap. And maybe in future, if you want to join further pipes, you can join this after removing this. We have other accessories products like siphon products. We have wash basin bottle traps. We have sink traps. We have washing machine traps with a 50 mm water seal guaranteed as per the NBC codes. The marking of the pipes as per the EN standards, all the pipes are marked with our brands, the sizes, the production date, the production time, everything is as per the standards. The marking of the fittings also follows the EN specification, the EN 1451, which is to be mandatory adhere for. If we talk about, let us go to the next topic, which is in continuation with our product, which we call as a drainage system. Now, if you see, this is a consolidated view of the drainage system, which shows about the lines which are coming from your house and ultimately connecting to the sewer lines for your municipality. So if you talk about drainage system, the drainage system is divided into two parts. One is a soil pipe, which carries wastewater from the water closets and urinals, also called black water. This pipe carries wastewater from the sanitary fixtures, like it includes showers, bathtubs, wash basin, kitchen, and it is called as a grey water. So if you see, the pipes are divided into two types. One is soil pipe and one is a waste pipe. Now the installation which has been followed entire world, if you see, there are three types of installation which has been followed. The first is the two pipe system, independent stacks for the soils and waste, which is generally followed and maximum followed in India. There is a one pipe system, combined stack for soil and waste with an anti-vent pipe systems. And the third is a single stack system. This combines the stacks for the soil and waste without any anti-siphonage pipes. Because the design is done in such a way that the anti-siphon is itself created inside the pipe itself. So let us, my topic today will be concentrating more on the single stack system. So let us understand what we are talking about, a single stack system. What is a single stack system? Single stack system commonly adopted in the European countries, but now few territories in India have also started adopting this particular system. And this system always follow a particular code, either it is a uniform international plumbing code, or it is follows NVC code, or your EN specifications, where suitable size pipe stack carries soils and waste drainage with a minimal venting requirement. In such cases, stacks shall be of a larger size to provide enough central air core to separate the vent pipes are avoided in this particular system. This is a schematic diagram of a single stack system, which we can see. This is a schematic diagram, but we can really design and give it to you also. Once a consultant gives us an AutoCAD drawing, we help them to design and give them the entire designs. And as per their design, we do also the value engineering for this particular product. So let us understand single stack system in more detail. So what happens? The flow of the liquid in a vertical drainage stack is restricted to 1/3 of its carrying capacity with a central core of movement of the air. A single stack system tries to avoid or minimize requirement for ventilating pipe by sizing the drainage stack sufficiently for carried liquid and the movement of the air. Single stack systems have other restrictions, like including the length of the branch which is horizontal. Single stack system have other restriction, including the length of the branch, soil waste and pipe connected to the drainage stack, and minimize the distance requirement between the connections of the stack. Many manufacturers, what they do is they have a proprietary product to receive the multiple staggered branch, which is called as an aerator. The products which they have invented is not in accordance with any standards, and there is no third party lab test to show its DFU handling, apart from the manufacturing testimony alone. Hulett provides double swept tea as well for more connections on the same floor. Let us go to the further, what are the codes which have been followed for the single stack system? Now, if you see the codes, the single stack system is probably the most economical system in the world. Okay, but proper planning has to be done right from the design stage and the architectural layout, where the washrooms will be there, where the bathrooms will be there, where the fixtures will be there. And on that basis, it has to be, if the design is made properly, then the plumbing can be minimized. So the code references which are given is National Building Code of India, which is 2016, and the EN 12056 Volume 2. Now, if you see what are the codes which are other followed, NBC code says, as per 2.69 piping systems, which is included in the part 9 of plumbing services, if you see the serial number F, a non-ventilated discharge pipe shall be connected to discharge stack with a swept junction having an angle of 87 to 88.5 degrees centigrade. This is what I was talking about, the swept T. The definition, if you go to the volume 2 of EN 10256 specification for a single stack system, here also if you go to the code 3.2.8, it is called a swept T entry, equal branch junction that is at 45 degrees or less, or has a center line radius not less than the internal pipe diameter. So here also you see a swept T which has been specified. You go to the UPC code for a single stack system, here also in the appendix C, your clause number 2.5, connection to the stack, a non-ventilated branch discharge pipe shall be connected to a discharge stack with a swept connection having an angle of 88.5 degree, figure 5. You see the figure on the right hand side, which I have shown, where the angle has to be maintained, which is again a swept T. Now, to calculate all this particular thing, obviously, there when the material falls, because this particular drainage system is always on a gravity system. So we have to calculate the terminal velocity also. The drainage is a gravity system where the drainage flow, one third tends to attach to the piping wall, forming a hollow cylinder of water with a core of air, two third in the center, and opposed by the friction force applied by the pipe asperity. This opposite force limits the water drains velocity to a value given by the following equation. On this basis, the velocity, terminal velocity has been calculated and the velocity breaker has to be designed. The drainage piping size. Now we have to design how to come to a particular diameter of a pipe. What are the parameters which you have to consider in this particular case? So in this case, what we do is sanitary sewers and vent plays a very important role in maintaining the maintaining the quality of the indoor vent environment of the building. Correct sizing is crucial for this particular proper functioning. Set charts are published in the International Plumbing Codes. The plumbing codes have been defined for this particular thing. Now, using this chart, there are four steps how you can accurately arrive at the diameter of the pipes which has to be used. So what you do, you add up the total number of drainage fixture units for each sanitary branch, determine the sanitary branch size using the DFU value. DFU is nothing but daily fixture units. Okay, so drainage fixture units, sorry. Calculate the size of the main building drains using the total of all the DFU values. Size the venting pipe using the IPC table or the DFU values. So once you size it, you will come to know the sizes of this. Now, if you consider the hydraulics as per the EN specification part 2, when the stack size is, suppose I have arrived at a stack size after all my DFU, my stack size is say 110. With a square T, I can achieve the maximum discharge capacity will be 4 liters, but with the swept T, I can go up to 5.2. If I put another secondary venting system for the same size, I can go up to 7.3 with a swept T discharge capacity. So we have a product what we call as a single swept T. The swept T are of various sizes, which ranges from 75 mm up to 160 mm in diameters. And we have a reduced swept T as well as equal swept T, which will be used for the single stack system. I'll just try to compare a little bit what is the difference between the aerator fittings and what is the swept T. If you see on the right hand side, we have the swept T which has been installed, which is quite easy to install because it is just a push arrangements. If you talk about the aerated fittings, this aerated fittings, we have to cut the side of the fittings, plane the ends of the fittings, do the welding at the workshop, press together and allow it to cool, and then take this particular to the site. So this is a cumbersome process, whereas the SWEFT-E, you just push it and you can install the pipes and everything. This is a schematic diagram which we have shown, where we show how we can use the SWEFT-E for a single stack system. If you see the left side diagram, which is a low in height diameter, low in height, the building, which is up to 10 meters. There we have shown a single stack system, flow diversion at a standard distance up to 10 meter stack. Here we have, what we have done is at the bottom, you will see 245 degrees bend, and then we have a 200 mm pipe so that when the material, when the solids or the liquid which flows down, we break the velocity and then we have a smooth flow down. You take about the second line where we say the flow diversion standard distance for the height riser stack sunken drainage system. Here what we do at the bottom, we give a relief line because the bottom where you will have a very high pressure. So we have to give a relief line, and the bottom WC is connected on a separate relief line. And then the water has been, the water or the soil has been discharged in a smoother flow after applying 245 degrees bend and carrying to a 2 meter horizontal lines. This is for the sunken area. Similarly, we do for the suspended area as well as for the columns where we are coming in the suspended area. Now I go to the next one. We play a video where I would like to go first to my playback slide. So 1 minute, sir. This shows about the single stack system, how it has been done. This was a small video for the presentation, which shows about the single stack system. Let us understand what was the highlight of the single stack system. What are the performance benefit? It minimizes stack dimensions, increased capacity compared to the secondary ventilated systems, reduce the pneumatic and hydraulic pressures. What are the cost benefits to the developers or to anybody? It saves valuable building space. The space is very, very crucial now everywhere. Saves installation times and material cost, less core drillings and passive fire safety solutions by removing secondary vent, low weight and durable recyclable plastic solution. So these are the highlights of the single stack system. If you talk about the references which we have done for the single stack system, these are a couple of references which I can show you. If you see, we have shown the couple of references, but I'll show you the photographs also, the completed sites. There are sites like Imperial Alpha, eTrend, Kalpataru's, then Odella, Oxford Residencies, Purple Pride, Parkland, Residency 91 Towers, this is in Mumbai, Signature Tower, the Spires, the Yashona, the Pride World City, Oxford Gold Resorts. These are some of the references. We have n number of references. We have thousands of references, India as well as internationally. And we have done buildings up to more than 70 floors also internationally with the SWEPTI. Now, if you see what standards we are following as a company, we are following the standards which is EN1451, EN13501, EN4102-2, and the Fraunhofer certificate, which is EN14366. And also we have green label certification for our product, for an ultra silent products. If you talk about approvals, like we have a number of approvals, which is quality related, environmental related, occupational related, health and safety, system approvals, every approvals, whatever has been designed, whatever the people ask, we can submit the approvals to you. Now let us go to the new products, which we are going to bring in into the market. We call it as a new product. We have a company called in Portugal, which is called as a Heliroma. It's called as a Juliet Heliroma. And that's from where the products will come in. We talk about new product, which is called as a Heliroma Red Fire. Red Fire, we're talking about fire and red in color. So obviously the product is for fire, a fire system. So what we say, the product is for PPR, fiberglass system, firefighting network installation, and new market segmentation. This is basically for the new market, which we are talking about now. What are the characteristics of this particular system? We have a diameter of this pipe from 25 mm to 125 mm, which is SDR 11. Color is red in color. Raw material is PPR. We have three layers here. It is the first layer is PPR. The second layer is PPR with flame retardant additives. And the third layer, the topmost layer, is made of PPR. If you talk about fire reaction classification, it follows into the classification of B-S1-D0. And the joining technique is basically thermofusion socket unions, or we call it as a thermofusion welding. Operating conditions are 12.5 bars at 20 degrees centigrade. And expected life or expected durability we talk about is 50 years for this particular system. The specifications which we follow is as per the EN specification, EN13501. Or what you call is a DIN specification 8077. We have various accessories. We have connectors, we have wall walls, we have saddles, whatever you mention, everything is with us in this particular product. If you talk about the other things, yes, in case of fire retardant, fire reaction classification, as I mentioned you, we follow B-S1-D0. If you talk about the classification level, generally the fire reaction classifications are A1, A2, which is a non-combustible. B2F is fuel in ascending orders. And complementary classification, if you say, which is basically for smoke production or emission, which is S1 to S3. Now S1 stands for absent, and up to when you go to S3, it is abundant. And drops of flame particles falls in D0 to D2, which is absent and abundant. And our product follows in D0, which is absent. Application, if you talk about, there are various application. This product has been certified by NOR. NOR is the certifying agency for the fire sprinkler systems. But we are in also the process of FM approvals for this particular product. This is a certificate for this particular product, which we have. Equipped fire hose cabinets. The red fire can be used as long as the minimum simultaneity of two FHS is guaranteed for at least 60 minutes. And diameter of FHS is from 25 mm to 45 mm. And this is suitable for fire protection in installation of low risk or medium risk. Examples of the buildings are hospitals, administrative building, parking lots, commercial centers. Fire sprinkler system, we are talking about an applications. Application, we are talking about wet piping systems and brand systems. If you talk about the risk area, we are talking about light risk area, active with low fire load, combustibility. Common risk area, which is CR, which is CR1 to CR4. Extra process risk area, we have subgroup of EPR1 to EPR4. And then extra storage risk, we are talking about ESR1 to ESR2. application sites, as I mentioned, we have various application sites where we can use in hospitals, hotels, industries, theaters, cinema, prisons, garage, and parking lots, which are very, very crucial. Product characteristics, we say raw material with a flame retardant additive. It is light in weight. PPR is always light in weight. Chemical stabilized, it is a stability because of the raw material property. It is fiberglass layer. It's 100% recyclable. And thermofusion socket welding. What are the benefits? It prevents sprinklers from clogging because it's generally in the metal piping system, what happens when you are trying to, if it is an MS or it is a galvanized iron, the pipe starts corroding. And the corrosion, the fire, ferric oxide, which is there, which is a form of particle, clogs the sprinklers when the time of operation comes in. But here there is no question of any corrosion. So it really doesn't prevent the sprinklers from clogging. It is easy to assemble. It reduces the maintenance. It has a higher reliability and it is durable material. A fire resistance I mentioned as BE-S1D0. It is sustainable and ecological. We have certification and more certifications we are trying to get through this for this particular material. It is lower installation and maintenance cost and lower thermal expansion for this particular material. So what are the key benefits? It's reliable, versatile, certifications are there and lower total cost. This is handling and transportation of this particular material, how to handle. This is more related to the site and more related how to handle this particular material. Installation, how to do the unloading and how to do the installation has been shown. And now I come to this, why Hooliard? Why people should use Hooliard? What are the advantages of using Hooliard? We say Hooliard gives a unique offer. It says 0% wastage. We say tailor-made options. Now, when you go to a tailor, you want to have a shirt stitch, okay? And that's why you have only the cut piece which you take, and he takes a measurement and he gives you a shirt. The same way we can give you a length of the pipe which is cut to sizes for your project. So the advantage is at the project, the labor doesn't have to waste the time for cutting, and that small cut piece will not go as a waste, okay? So it reduces what you call as a waste of the material at the site, no more cutting at the site. What happens then? What is the advantage of this? It saving on the cost. Pay for what you use, saving on labor, saving installation time, saving on disposing this waste material due to cutting of the pipes at the site. You avoid pollution also at the site, avoid environmental pollution also, because otherwise generally the cut pieces are always thrown in the waste, in the dustbins or anywhere, or it is generally dumped at the site itself. It is 100% green product. So we say we reduce the carbon footprints in this particular case. Again, why Hooliard? We say we give complete basket of innovative solution. We were only into drainage, but slowly and steadily we are coming into drinking water system also, the potable water system. We are coming in firefighting system also, and we are also coming into the STP. We are already started STP, that is waste treatment plant. So if you see, we are right from the entry till the exit. Everything is there with us now. We give technical support for design and value engineering, which helps us, which we call is an additional hand to the consultants and engineers at the site. We are committed to the timely delivery. We have field staff support 24/7. The main thing is manufacturing in India. So make in India concept, Atmanirbhar. And we have a reference list of project with successful installation in India. So the last what I would like to say is I would like to give a big thank you to BMLPA, that is Brian Mimer Licensed Plumber Association, giving me a opportunity to present my product in this particular forum. Thank you very much. And I'm open to the questions now.
Thank you, Sailesh Bhai. May I request people who have any question and answers to please, if they have an option to raise the hand, please raise the hand and ask a question. Or if you do not have that option available, please go one by one. And I'm sure Sailesh Bhai will be more than happy to answer everybody's questions. I've seen a certain hand being raised by Mr. Vinod Jagalan. So Mr. Vinod, did you have a question? People who have questions, please unmute your mic and you can ask any questions that you may have.
Chintan, I have one for Shailesh.
Yes, please. Yes, please.
As per your presentation, you don't have 75 mm swept tee.
We have 20, 75 mm. We have what we call 100 and 75 by 110.
No, okay. But here what happens is generally your toilet WC is in the center of external wall.
Yes.
Under the window, and your floor traps are in one side.
Yep.
So most of the times the floor traps are connected to swept tee, or initially it was connected to door tee. So right. I think you need to have 75 mm swept tee, maybe door swept tee.
Okay.
And secondly, you were mentioning about some ultra seal, right?
Yeah. That is,
whenever you come, or you can, you know, have sort of access to me.
Yes.
Please send some samples to me. Sorry, bring some sample to me.
Okay, sir.
Right, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll bring it, sir. Definitely.
Any further questions, please? I think there's a hand raised by Mr. Pragnesh Patwana. Pragnesh bhai, please go ahead and ask your question. Please unmute your mic and feel free to ask your
question. Yes, please.
What are the limitations? The height. What I'm understanding is that yes, we can use the 100 mm pipe for a single stack, but then without the venting provision done, what is the maximum height that we can think about for the single stack?
See, we are talking about not only 110 mm pipe. I just gave an example of 110 mm pipe. We have got the size up to 200 mm in diameter. Okay. So if you really see, I also mentioned in my references also, we have done single stack system with a swept tee for a 70 floor and as a more than 70 floor story building also.
Okay, so then what are the limitations? Up to what height can we use 110 mm dia pipe?
See, 110 can go up to your 40 meter, less than 40 meter of size, height, sir.
40 meters?
Yeah.
Okay. So beyond that, we'll have to go to 150 or 200, whatever the case
is. We have got a size for, like say, we have got 75, 110. I mean, our size starts from 32, but if you talk about the higher sizes, then 75, 110, 125, 160 and 200, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
So do we have any kind of chart wherein we can specify though, irrespective of the diffuse, this is the maximum height one pipe can cater to.
We can, we have that. We have a design manual. In the design manual, we can circulate the design manual to you. But the diameter of the pipe is generally calculated on the DFU. Okay.
Yeah.
So DFU.
Yeah.
Once the DFUs are calculated, you have to follow the national NBC code, or you have to follow the Uniform Plumbing Code, which has been defined very clearly. At this particular flow rate, you will require this particular diameter of the pipe.
Okay. So you can share that table with us.
Yeah, we can share the table with you, sir.
Might be share it with me, and I can share it to the entire forum, to all our members.
Sure, I will send it to you, Pranesh bhai, and then we can share it again.
Yes, definitely. Thank you.
Stylish, why can't you do one thing?
Yes, sir.
Right now, we don't have a publication of our bi-monthly magazine, Plumworld, in BMLPA.
Yes, sir.
But the moment we start printing, why can't you give us some write-up on these subjects?
No problem. I'll send you, let me know when your publications are starting, we'll give you a write-up on that. Definitely.
Send it as early as possible. We might start by next issue.
Okay, sir. Definitely, sir.
I have one question, so I have raised my hand also.
Yes, please, sir.
Shailesh bhai, I actually have two questions. One thing is, Hulliet being a very global kind of a company, and the way things are evolving, everything is moving on to BIM and 3D coordination when it comes to designing, especially in our case. So I just had a question that does Hulliet as a company have Revit or BIM libraries available ready as per the DFUs?
Yes, it is available, sir. Not in India, but we'll try. We are bringing in India also later on. But in Israel, yes, definitely it is available, sir.
Okay. And the second question was regarding the fire pipes.
Yes.
What are the local approvals that we have as terms, say, for example, Mumbai CFO?
See, currently I told you this is the product which we are bringing in. This is just we launch it in Portugal right now. Okay.
Okay.
We are working on the FM approval. Once I get an FM approval, after that only I will be approaching the firefighting systems here, sir.
Understood.
Yep.
Yeah, any further questions, anybody, please feel free to ask questions. We do not have a hall to empty here, so we have a lot of time.
Chintan bhai, also I will tell you, Rivet is also available in India also now. I'm sorry on that, but I just went through my link also, and then I found it. Yes, it is available also in India also.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah. Chintan, are we recording this and will be sharing YouTube link?
Yes.
Okay.
So please, attendees, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them.
Or else we will go to Shailesh Khama for a lovely cake.
Yes, please.
Yes. So for those
all who are invited,
later,
all are invited.
Let me once again remind everybody, it is Shailesh Bhai's birthday today. So once again, a very happy birthday from everybody. Yes, I see a question has come up from Mr. Manish Parikh.
Yes.
Manish Bhai, please unmute yourself and feel free to ask the question. Manish bhai, are you able to unmute yourself? In case you are not able to unmute yourself, you can send out a WhatsApp message on the Tech Savvy or the BMLPA group, and we will ask it here.
Any other questions anybody has, please feel free.
Now with this, I would like to inform every member of TechSavvy, BMLP, or whosoever has joined today that there will be a regular webinar on every Saturday around 4 o'clock on different subjects and different products. So please have the contact number of the people from whom you got the link today. We will be sharing it with Mr. Shailesh and a lot of people from BMLP and TechSavvy. So try to be there. Thank you.
Sure.
Just to continue what was just said, the link will always remain the same, and we will be trying our best to get the best speakers in the country every Saturday. The link always remains the same. The coming Saturday, which is the 15th of August, the Independence Day, there's going to be a presentation. There's going to be a webinar on hot water supply solutions. So do remember to log in at the same link. It'll be the details of the same will be recirculated all over again, but the link always remains the same. So this is our exclusive Tech Savvy people's link, which can always stay open. It's like an open house. Please come here to learn something new.
Sure.
Secondly, next Saturday we'll be having on pipe supports.
Okay, so I believe I don't see a lot of any questions coming up. Can you please check, Papa, if anything has come up on WhatsApp as a question so that...
I'll check.
If anybody has a question, please, you can write it on the email also to me. If it is more related to my product, I'm ready to answer all your queries, whatever is required.
No, my email I don't see any. I don't see any.
Okay.
And Shailesh,
yes.
Shailesh bhai, can you share your number or email ID?
Yes,
yeah, that's
I will share it. If you want, I can right now tell you. It is Shailesh, Shailesh, @huliet.in. And
Shailesh,
my number.
Shailesh, you can share it on WhatsApp.
I'll put it on the TechSavvy group. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Deepak bhai. Thank you, Chintan.
So last time I'm asking if there are no further questions. I will ask Dad to please offer a vote of thanks for this event.
My God, this is a bad duty. Now, thanking our own people. Okay. First of all, thank you, Sailesh. You accepted my invitation. Second, thanks to Chintan, who is sitting in the office right now and hosting this. I am sitting at home. He is in the office. And all the participants who have taken keen interest in joining this webinar, please keep it up and be a part of knowledge sharing sessions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks for giving us the time and opportunity for this particular thing, sir.
Thank you, everybody, for joining in.
I'll
see you again on Saturday.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chintan. Great work. Bravo. Thank you, Sailesh.
Thank you, sir. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Sailesh, I wish you a very happy birthday.
Thank you.
Okay.
In Corona time.